Hey folks, one of the most important things that you have to have in your homeschooling journey is to be encouraged. There are times that we in the Smith house, so we get discouraged like everybody else. And when those times happen, I try to go to the scriptures. And one of my favorite scriptures on discouragement is whenever David was living with the Philistines, being on the run from King Saul. At that time, King Saul attacked the Philistines, and because David was a man of honor, he thought it was his responsibility to go fight for the Philistines who were protecting him. He and his men walked 3 days to the battlefront, only to have their integrity and their honor in question, because the leaders of the Philistines thought they might join the Hebrews to get back in Saul's favor. And so they sent them back home to Ziklag, where they were living. So imagine this, 3 days there, 3 days back, 6 days they're walking all day long. Their honor had been questioned. And as they got close to Ziklag, they saw a wisp of smoke going up, and they started to run as fast as they could that last half mile or so, only to find that their wives, their children, and their possessions had been taken by a raiding army of the Amalekites. But of course, when you think things can get no worse, they can get worse. Because David's men were so distraught, they spoke of stoning their leader. Can I say it's lonely at the top sometimes? So what did David do? The Bible says in 1 Samuel 30 that David encouraged himself in the Lord. And that's what I want to encourage you to do today, is learn how to encourage yourself whenever tough times come. Because tough times don't last, but tough people do. I'm going to share several thoughts over the next few weeks on how to encourage yourself in the homeschooling journey. Let's just focus on one thing today, and that is the sovereignty of God. Now, that's kind of popular verbiage today. We hear that phrase, God's sovereignty, a lot. But do we really think about what it means? To me, it means that God is sovereign over or in charge over every single detail in our lives. Both those details that we think are good and those details that we think are bad, God is over all. That means a couple of things. First of all, every season is measured by God. We see this most clearly with Job, that when the devil tried to attack Job, God gave him certain parameters in which he could not traverse in order to tempt Job past his ability to withstand the temptation. So God sets the measurements. Everything that comes into your life is measured by God. He knows just what you can take according to His omnipotent vision. Secondly, and equally important with that is, not only does God give permission at the beginning, He says enough at the end. As a matter of fact, when we start this thing, God already has the end appointed. Those are two good things to remember when you go through challenging seasons, okay? This is measured by God. It's for His glory, for my betterment. And just as this thing has started, it will end someday according to God's divine timeline. Does that make sense? So I hope you'll take this story from David and seek to encourage yourself in the homeschooling journey. This is Kirk Smith with ICHE's Take 5.